the elite men this morning, the thoughts of some of those in contention, Kulhavi, Lakata. Look at all those star riders on the front there. Yellow jerseys, Investec Songo Specialized. The red of Ellsworth ASG, Stuart Maria and his partner, Habib Kruger, in the Absa African jersey. And they head off on these open trails at the moment in the basin of the Breda River Valley, but it gets a lot tougher a little bit later on. I think this week has been blessed by cooler conditions, which has really been a blessing for a lot of the riders. They may come over the mountain here to the real Boerland area here and feel the heat today, as it's going to get a lot hotter.
Yeah, I think as the racing is hotting up, I think so is the temperatures. Yeah. And today, sitting here in Wellington at the moment, it's definitely a lot warmer than it was yesterday.
If you happen to just be tuning in to our coverage of the Absa Cape Epic, we started on Sunday on Table Mountain at the prologue, and then out to Robertson for three nights there, a couple of wonderful stages out there, and the transition stage yesterday, stage three, to Worcester. And that's the vagaries of stage racing, a week-long event. I mean, you go to work, you can get ill, and so you just want to manage yourself as you go through this race. This is now earlier this morning down towards the Brunfly Dam, which is what they came past from the other angle yesterday.
You can see the Canada boys right to the front here, trying to apply pressure to this pack and hoping to shed some riders that are feeling a little bit weak.
So Mweli Poro is the rider just behind Manuel Fumic there in the German champions jersey. Is Manuel Fumic, and Mweli Poro from Czech Celeste Marco is in the frame there. Look who's on the front once more. The Czech Express, Kulhavi.
I think for some of the teams that are slightly down on the overall standings, they might have thought today might be a chance for them to try and get away off the front, to try and get a stage win, because of the big time gap to back to them. The leaders of the race might think it's fine, let them go up the road. But because the front end of the field is so tight, they won't let anyone go off the front, because they are actually racing to try and get away.
Caught a glimpse there of the Silverback OMX team of Martin Gluth and Raphael Gagne, the Canadian, riding his first Absa Cape Epic. So a big challenge for him, and he found it tough. This man is racing his first one. He was here last year, Howard Grotz, but he was in a support role to Christoph Sauza and Jaroslav Kulhavi, a very different role to the one he's got now, the responsibility of riding with Jaroslav Kulhavi. And you get the feeling, as the week has gone on, it's starting to take a toll on young Howard Grotz. He'll be digging very, very deep today to hang on to Kulhavi.
For sure. I think yesterday we saw towards the end of the stage where, because Investec Songo Specialized suffered two mechanical issues, they had to chase back, and every time they had to chase, Kulhavi would go onto the front and would actually put Grotz into the hurt box, and really he suffered on those sections trying to get back to the front, or to Topic, and then, or to Canyon, and then that actually cost them in the end.
Noticeable here that they are missing from this group. This is still quite early this morning, but at the back, the Martin Gluth for Silverback OMX. And if you'd seen that previous shot, you could just see in the background Kulhavi come around the corner and sort of look over his shoulder and wait a little bit. So I think Investec Songo Specialized are going to be right on the limit today as their pressure is applied by Cannondale Factory Racing. Remember, 3 minutes and 14 seconds between the first three teams in the overall GC. So there's absolutely nothing to play with here on a big stage like today, because Cannondale Factory, Canyon Topic, 3:14 off the lead. Quite a big gap then, 18 minutes back to Centurion, Vauder, Robach and Giesmeier.
So a similar situation here again, where Kulhavi is on the front trying to get Grotz back to the leaders. Grotz struggling a little bit with the sand, and today's start here, there was a bit of...
Still have plenty in reserves.
Yeah, the riders here heading into the Torres Kloof mountain bike network of trails, and lovely trails that have been developed in this area over the past few years.
All together now, you see the bulls there, there's Centurion Vader, Grotz a little bit further back, Samueli Poro there from Trek Celis and Marco as well. Franz Klaas there, the Belgian, also in the mix. But they just hit a little patch of sand there, and you can see riders who are not too familiar with it just losing a meter or two as that sand patch strikes them. It almost sucks you in.
Yeah, it sucks you in. And if you're struggling with rhythm already and you hit one of those sections, or your line is slightly off, you find yourself getting sucked in and just bogged down and just struggling to to accelerate again. And the problem with that is it's fine if it happens once or twice or three times.
Now, isn't this what makes this event just spectacular? Look at these trails, absolutely amazing. And the evolution of trails in this part of the world has so much to do with the APSA Cape Epic over the years. The riders have come through here many years ago. These trails didn't exist then, but farmers and trail gurus have got to embrace mountain biking, and mainly through the exposure to it via the APSA Cape Epic, and are building some amazing trails.
For sure, this area, having ridden in this area quite a bit, it's amazing riding. The trails are not as manicured as you get closer to Cape Town, but the trails are more natural and more pure mountain biking type of terrain. Dual suspension is a must in this area.
Absolutely. It's rocky, it's loose, it's unforgiving, and these riders will know that only too well. Canyon Toe Peak, bulls on the front there as well, trying to do something today. Carl Platt looked a little bit forlorn this morning on the start line, still battling to get back to his top form. He broke his pelvis there as well, so they're all hunting down that little hot spot and back onto the single track and the climb nine. There's no question that Cannondale Factory Racing are dead keen to do something today.
You could see they were riding with intent from the start, and they would also take confidence from seeing that Grot struggling a little bit, and they think there's an opportunity here to gain some ground. And I think if you've got a bad day today and you find yourself off the back, not in the front groups, going over the final challenge of the day, the Bainscroft Pass, you might see yourself lose a significant amount of time.
Yeah, this is what they know, Cannondale Factory Racing. They've come back the last couple of years. They're learning this event. They wore the yellow jersey last year for 4 days, and they want to have it on the day that counts most. That is on the grand finale day into Val d'Avis. By the way, it's at Val d'Avis near Paarl, just outside Paarl, just off the N1. So if you're around the Western Cape, come and watch these superstars of the sport and the real heroes, of course. There are 1,200 riders taking on this challenge, and they'll all be rolling in. Let's hope virtually every single one of them rolling into the finish at Val d'Avis.
These guys out there for 5 hours every day, where other guys are for 10 hours. Here we can see the mention of the hotspot coming up.
Yep, they want the little prize to Nicola Robach and Daniel Gesmeyer, and they charge ahead to try and get a bit of a break, and they are going to snaffle the Dimension Data hotspot. Gesmeyer and Robach, there we go, over the line. Well played, the Centurion Vardar men. Little fist pump in celebration. They're not out of contention by any stretch of the imagination, but they sit 10 minutes and 37 seconds down into the water point very quickly.
Yeah, and quickly refill here at the Toys Kloof Winery, and you got the sense there that the other teams, they didn't really care too much about the hotspot. It was more for the teams that are not going for the overall win today. Although,
here we go, we're on the road now of Baines Kloof.
Everybody's together as far as I can see. Cannondale is there in Wessex Songo Specialized Bulls, the Spanish Scott Buff, Britain, and Canyon.
Are they there? Who's on the front there? That may be them.
On the front is Bulls.
Bulls on the front?
I don't think quickly to dinner.
Right now, that's live pictures, and that is the leader. That's the lead group. That's Robach and Gesmeyer of Centurion Vardar. Look over the shoulder there. They're working really, really hard, which will tell you this is a little bit of an incline, and they have escaped the group.
It looks like they're looking back. They can't be too far ahead, since they look quite nervous looking over their shoulder, but it's very, very short here to the finish.
So they're closing in on the finish. Well, the Centurion Vardar, Nicola Robach and Daniel Gesmeyer won the prologue. They were fourth at the start of the day today.
And you see the difference between the who is
back on the podium. Here's the chase group.
Yara in the front, putting the hammer down. It looks like Cannondale is not in there. I wonder if they're in the front or in the back.
So it's at least Investec Songo Specialized, Bab Scott, and the Bulls are right in there, and that's Carl Platt and Urs Huber at the sharp end. Almost for the first time we've seen them in the mix here, where it matters most.
You see they're so close, wheel on wheel, and also next to it. It's good that the bikes now have through axle, which is
an excellent ride. We'll have to find out exactly where they gapped in Bainscliff, somewhere along the line, either near the top or on the descent, early on the descent, and they've managed to make that work for them. Gesmeyer and Robach will turn the right now into the school. Kulhavi, Grotz, and Pinto and Carretero. The tenth to their right, so that's how close it is. But it's not going to be close enough. Victory on stage four, the Queen stage, to Centurion Varas, Nicola Robach and Daniel Gesmeyer. They are right in the mix here at the Absa Cape Epic. They'll be eating into second and third place, but the yellow jerseys of Yaroslav Kulhavi and Howard Grotz will take second place and consolidate their position in yellow. Their closest rivals are some way back. And Buff Scott back on the podium once more. Pinto and Carretero. The Spanish-Portuguese alliance have done it again. They're on the podium.
What went down there and got you so far in front?
Yeah, the Cannondale boys, they pushed really hard in the single trail, and yeah, we was behind in the group with the overall leaders. And then, yeah, in a really rocky single trail, Yara had some problems. Then we took the lead part. And in the end, I mean, like, where's the really real climb starts? We close the gap to the Cannondale guys, and then we attack on the uphill. And yeah, super happy to do.
Well, congratulations on the stage win. Enjoy the celebrations.
Thanks.